Hi, I'm out here in the Mojave Desert looking for Ventifacts. This is an area of an old alluvial fan. And over the years, the wind has blown away a lot of fine grain materials, and down on the surface here, this is a partial desert pavement. Ventifacts are formed when wind picks up the sand, bounces it along, hits the rocks, and creates a facet on one side of the rock. So if there's enough sand and enough wind and enough time, we'll end up having some ventifacts being created here. So I'm going to take a look over in the hills over here, take a look in the low areas at least, and see if we can find any ventifacts. Ah, here's a nice one here. You can tell the ventifacts are ventifacts because of the facets and the ridge that separates them. So here's one in place. And by looking at the facets, you can tell basically the direction of the wind that created them. This flat surface right here was created by wind blowing sand along, impacting this surface and cutting a facet. And also the wind coming from this direction, cutting this facet over here, and yet a third direction coming in from basically the north to cut this one. So it has three faceted surfaces and three ridges that separate. Let's come in for a closer look here. All right, let's take a look. Let me turn this a little bit so maybe you can see those flat sides a little better. All right. And a lot of the rocks that have been sitting out in the desert for a long time have this rusty brown color beneath. This is due to a little bit more oxidation. Sitting out here like this for hundreds or thousands of years, every once in a while it rains, and the water can collect under the rocks, remain there for a little longer, and the iron minerals that are in it end up oxidizing a bit. So this ventifact has those faces on it, as you can see, the ridges separating them, and this rusty brown color beneath the surface. This is not a protected area, so I think this one will head back to Phoenix with us. The desert out here is really loaded with ventifacts. Here's yet another. This is kind of a smaller one, smaller than fist size. And if I turn a little bit, we can see some of the facets as well as the ridge that separates the facets. Let's take a closer look at this one. Okay, here it is again. What I wanted to show you is that this is basically a piece of basalt, but it's porphyritic. It has phenocrysts of feldspar. Here's a nice crystal right there. So you can see this flat surface right here is a facet. Here's the ridge that separates one facet from another. Continue on that, and over on this side is another facet with ridges. Here's another nicely formed ventifact. Again, here's the ridge, a facet on this side, a facet here, another ridge on this side. And as I was saying, these are produced by windblown sand. So the sand is bouncing along, saltating, hitting the surface of this chunk of basalt, and over hundreds or thousands of years, it manages to grind a surface, fairly flat, fairly smooth. So let me get this out of the dirt here a little bit. Well, it's a little bigger than I thought. All right, more of that reddish-brown color on the bottom here. But again, nice shape. Let me just turn it a little bit so you can see some of the facets and the ridges that separate them. So this is a ventifact. This is a feature that is unique to deserts because with a lot of rain, these rocks would have been moved, would have been eroded. So they have to sit in place for thousands of years, and the action of the wind and the sand beating on them creates these faceted rocks, right? Ventifacts.
Here's this small porphyritic basalt ventifact collected out in the Mojave Desert. As I said, it was basically basalt, but with lots of crystals of feldspars. And these feldspar crystals would be considered the phenocrysts that are in the basalt. So this is a porphyritic basalt with phenocrysts of feldspar. Let me put it in motion so that you can see the various facets and the ridges that separate the facets. So that's a facet there. Here comes the ridge. Another facet here. And another ridge, and another facet. So this is an excellent example of a ventifact.